deliver you the lecture on the your syllabus related crystal structure, particularly for TY BSc physics. So matter occurs in the three state, basically solid, liquid and gases. There is also fourth state is a plasma, but we will today talk about only solid state. Now, what are the solids? Basically, solid are the classified into three categories again, based on the atomic arrangement within the solid. So we know very well the solid have its own mass, density, shape, size, everything. So this solid is nothing but we say that crystal. So crystal, so definition, the solid which have a regularity in atomic and molecular structure are known as crystal. So crystal is again classified into three categories: single crystalline solid, polycrystalline solid, and amorphous solid. So crystal in which the orientation of atoms or molecules is uniform through the intercrystal is called single crystalline solid, or we say that single crystal. So in this structure or in this solid, the orientation of atom is periodically throughout the crystal is the same. An example of such crystal is quartz diamond. So after this, second type is a polycrystalline solid. A solid is made up of smaller crystalline, we call it grain, but orientation of atoms or molecules in each grain is different than neighbor. Such solid is called as polycrystalline solid. I mean, the solid is made up from various small grain, but in each grain there is a regular periodic arrangement of atom, but orientation is different. Such solid is called as polycrystalline solid, and the example of such solid is almost all metals. Then third is a amorphous solid, a solid in which orientation of atoms or molecules are not regular. We say that is the molecules are your atoms are in the random positions. Such solid is called amorphous solid, and the example of such solid is called rubber, plastic, glass, so many. So after the we understand the crystalline solid, polycrystalline solid, amorphous solid, we see how the solid or how the crystal is formed. Basically, the crystal is formed due to lattice point and basis. Now, what is a lattice? An arrangement of infinite number of imaginary points array in 3D space, in each point having the identical surrounding, is known as crystal lattice, lattice, or space lattice. So it is just an arrangement array, imaginary, of 3D, is called lattice. It is also called as Bayes lattice. Basis is what? The structure of all crystal is described in terms of lattice with a group of atoms attached to each lattice point This group is called bases or atomic bases, which may consist of atoms or ions or even molecules. At one lattice point, suppose if single atom is accumulating, we call that such solid is called as monocrystalline solid. If there is a two atom is accumulated, atom ion or molecule, then we call it a diatomic structure. If three, then tie and so on. So crystal structure is formed when the basis is attached to every point of lattice, it is due the crystal structure. Means lattice plus basis equal to crystal structure. Until and unless the student are not seated on the desk or bench, the class will be not completed. When, means simple way, the lattice arrangement is nothing but your desk arrangement. And when student consider students are atoms, when they will sit it on your bench, then the crystal will be formed, or then the class will be formed. So arrangement of your bench in the class is always regular, repetitive in two dimensions. Whenever the student will come in the class and they will sit in the class, then class will be formed. In the same way, at every lattice point, it is a three-dimensional array, imaginary point where the atom is accumulated in, then the crystal is formed. So that's why we can say that in lattice plus basis equal to crystal structure. So what is the translation vector? The translation vector is the distance through which the atom must be moved or translate in order to be the next unit cell in 2D. So consider A and B are lattice points. Here I shown here the A and B are lattice points. Here is a A and here is a B. So OA is a A vector, small a vector, and OB is a small b vector. All other lattice points can be obtained with respect to origin O by translation vector P, such that a translation vector P, we can write down the N1 small a vector, N2 small b vector, where N1 and N2 are integers and A and B are called translation vector along the particular your vector. So crystals are made up of infinitely number of unit cells. Now it is clear for us. Now what is a unit cell? So unit cell is the smallest unit of crystal, which if repeated could generate the whole crystal. A unit cell is the smallest building block in your crystal. And wherever this unit cell is repeated periodically, yes. Anybody want to ask something? So crystal is made by a various unit cell, or whole crystal is made by various unit cell, and it is in the periodical arrangement. So here in the unit cell, the vector A, B, C are called primitive translation vector. If primitive translation vector are used to construct the unit cell, then it is called as primitive unit cell. If not primitive translation vector are used to construct the unit cell, then it is called as non-primitive unit cell. It should be noted that here, in primitive unit cell, the all lattice points are located at only the corner. But in non-primitive unit cell, the translation vector, lattice points are located in the head center, a center, or corner, or even body center. So such unit cell is called as non-primitive unit cell. A crystal's unit cell dimension are defined by six numbers. We call it the length of axis A, B, C, and the interaxial angles alpha, beta, and gamma, called as lattice parameters. So A, B, C, suppose there is a three axis and alpha, beta, gamma is an angle between your A, B, B, C, and C, A respectively. So every unit cell is our structure is characterized by five points. First is the number of atoms per unit cell. It is denoted by capital N, means how much number of atoms located within that area of your one unit cell. We have to determine the number of atoms in a unit cell. So how we can determine it? There is particular formula for each structure. So it is the sum of fully shared and partially shared atoms in a unit cell is called number of atoms per unit cell. So N, capital N equal to NC upon A plus NE upon 4 plus NF upon 2 plus NB upon 1. So NC, NE, NF, and NB is what? NC is the total number of atoms located at a corner of a unit cell. Of course, it is depends on the so that which type of structure is there. It should be NE. Okay. So NE is the total number of atoms located on the edges of the unit cell. Then NF, total number of atoms located at a face of the unit cell. And NB is a total number of atoms located in a body center of your unit cell or even inside the body of your unit cell. So we can determine using this formula how much total number of atoms is in your one unit cell. That's why we call it a per unit cell. Coordination number, scientifically, it does not important, but it is the number of nearest neighbor atom that an atom placed in the lattice point in a unit cell called as coordination number. Suppose that this is one structure here. So I shown there one lattice point. So that lattice point is, suppose here is O, and this lattice point have an atom. So how much number of neighbor atom touch to this atom is called as coordination number of that structure. So here is a one atom, then two atom, three atom, four atom, five atom, and six atom. They are all are touched to the that lattice point. So that's why coordination number of such structure is a six. If you consider this lattice point, so in that case, suppose if you consider, instead of your O, if you consider another lattice point, so suppose this atom So here is a one. Here will be second. This is third. Then four. Fifth. And so any letter spread, because crystal is made up of infinitely three-dimensional structure of unit cell. So the unit cell is in the three-dimensionally. So that's why the same environment is there. So that's why every lattice point will be have same, every lattice point will be have same number of atoms neighbor to each, that atom. So that's why we call it a coordination number. Next is the atomic radius. So what is atomic radius? So atomic radius in case of ionic crystal is different. But if the environment is same, or we say that it is a pure element, then we can define its atomic radius. It is a half of the distance between two nearest neighbor atoms of the same kind. जर तुमचे दोन सारखे ऍटम असतील, इफ द नेबर ऍटम आर सिमिलर वन, देन दे विल हॅव द सेम रेडियस अँड द हाफ ऑफ दॅट डिस्टन्स फ्रॉम युअर सेंटर टू सेंटर इज द ॲटॉमिक रेडियस. अँड इन अ क्युबिक क्रिस्टल सेंटर, क्युबिक क्रिस्टल स्ट्रक्चर, वी हॅव हियर द लॅटाइस पॅरामीटर ए. सो वी कॅन राईट डाऊन फ्रॉम फिगर R plus R equal to A, or twice R equal to A, or hence we get here the atomic radius R equal to A up by 2. So simple definition, it is a half of the distance between nearest neighbor. Half of the distance means center to center at the same point of atom. So that's why we call it the atomic radius. So what is the atomic packing fraction, or we call it also packing density? So it is the ratio of total volume occupied by atoms to the total volume of a unit cell. So we have to be determined here how much volume occupied by atoms in atom in a one unit cell, and then how much or what is the volume of that unit cell. So we can determine atomic packing fraction is equal to number of atoms per unit cell multiplied by volume of the one atom upon volume of
Patil sir, kindly unmute yourself. Patil sir.
Okay, sir. Okay. So atomic radius is nothing but the half of distance between your nearest neighbor to atom, and atomic packing fraction, it is the ratio of total volume occupied by atom to the total volume of the unit cell. So here is the volume of atom upon volume of a unit cell, and hence the volume of atom, we can determine the number of atom per unit cell multiplied by volume of a one atom divided by volume of a unit cell. So number of atom per unit cell we determine by with capital N letters. So we can write down the atomic packing fraction equal to N, capital N, multiplied by 4 by 3 pi r cube is the volume of a one atom, or we can, it's a sphere. And if the system is a cubic, then we have here in cubic system A is equal to B is equal to C, and then the volume of unit cell will be A cube. We have to be determine, or we can determine the whole space or empty space in a unit cell in a percentage 1 minus APF multiplied by 100. So we'll get here the how much empty space in a 1 unit cell. So beside this, we have here the, today we are going to be learn 4-5 structure. So what is that structure and what kinds of, let us parameter we can determine for that particular structure. So first structure is a simple cubic structure. So simple cubic structure, in this structure, A is equal to B equal to C, that is a lattice parameter, and the angle between your axis, we say is a alpha equal to beta equal to gamma equal to 90 degree. So example of such structure is a copper, silver, iron, NaCl, CaCl, etc. Lot of example is there. So this is the arrangement of your cell where the all atoms are located at corner atom. There is no face center, no body center, no edge center. So that's why it is very easy to determine in this case number of average number of atom per unit cell is equal to, so we have here number of corner atom is a total 8 corner atom is here. So 8 divided by 8. Why now 8 divided by 8? Because the atom is located at a corner in a cubic crystal structure, then its contribution in a unit cell is 1 by 8. It is a contribution of that atom is 1 by 8. That's why we divide by the total number of atom by 8. So if you count it, how much number of atom in this unit cell, so we will find here the total 8 number of atom is a, in a unit cell. So here is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and 8. So total 8, that's why we write down here 8 upon 8. Then plus there is a no edge center atom because contribution of edge center atom in a cubic crystal is a 1 by 4. Contribution of face center is a 1/2. And contribution of your body center is a total 1. So that's why 8 by 8 plus 0 by 4 plus 0 by 2 plus 0 by 1 all together will be only 1 atom inside a 1 unit cell. In case of simple cubic structure, we call it a SC, simple cubic. So now it is clear for you how we can determine the number of atom per unit cell in a unit, 1 unit cell. So here is a, in case of simple cubic structure, number of atom in 1 unit cell is a 1 only. Now what is coordination number? Just earlier we have determined it. Coordination number definition is what? The maximum nearest neighbor atom touch to the any atom which is located at your lattice point. So consider that here is a lattice point is, suppose we consider here lattice point is a this one, suppose just 1 minute, okay, this one. So this atom will be touched to this atom, then there will be the next neighbor to here, 1 atom. So second atom is a third atom, then there will be again here 1 atom, then this atom, and there will be again 1 atom. So if you count this number of atom, neighbor to that lattice atom, will be getting here 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So total coordination number of the structure is a 6. It's a very simple to determine it. Okay, dear student, are you hearing me? Hello? Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Continue. Please continue.
Okay. So,
yeah.
In this case, the coordination number is the same. Now, atomic radius, as per definition, or according to definition, we can write the R plus R equal to A, because the definition is it is the distance, half of distance to the center to center of nearest neighbor atom of a same kind. So we have here same kind structure. So R plus R is equal to A, and hence atomic radius R equal to A by 2. So atomic packing pressure or density, we can determine as it is cubic crystal. So we already write in the first line, A is equal to B equal to C. So volume of this unit cell is A cube. So now substitute the all value in your formula. APF is equal to capital N into pi, 4 by 3. Pi R cube upon volume of unit cell is nothing but A cube. So number of atom capital N is equal to 1. So we substitute the value of your capital N is a N. So we substitute here the value N, 1. Then 4 by 3 pi R cube. So atomic radius is A by 2. We substitute this value A by 2 cube upon A cube. So if you do the calculation, so we will get here the APF is equal to, after simplification, pi by 6, and that is nothing but the value is, if you substitute value of pi is 3.14, so we'll get here the answer 0.52 is the APF. In the percent, we can determine is a 52%. So total volume of a simple cubic structure, in a simple cubic structure, atoms occupies by 52%, and remaining is the empty space, we call it the odd space. We can determine by this formula, 1 minus 0.52 into 100, that is 0.48 multiplied by 100 equal to 48%. So this is the APF and odd space of your simple cubic structure. So similar way, we can determine the same for your another structure. Suppose in a body center cubic structure, so BCC is there. Again in this structure, we have A is equal to B equal to C, and alpha equal to beta equal to gamma equal to 90 degree. But it is quite different compared to your simple cubic structure. Because in a simple cubic structure, all lattice horror atoms are neighbor to the just a lattice atom. But in this case, the lattice atom is not neighbor to the lattice atom. They are neighbor to the body center atom. The body center atom are have attached with your 8 number of atom, that all 8 number of atom located at your 8 corner of a unit cell. And the example of such structure is again different kinds of example is there. But in this case, we cannot directly determine the atomic radius, even number of atoms. In the last question is a very simple, but in this case, the average number of atoms per unit cell, that is capital N equal to, there are 8 atoms located at 8 corners, that's why 8 upon 8 is there, plus no S center, no face center. But there is one body center, that's why 1 upon 1, and therefore, if you calculate it, you will get total number of atoms in a 1 unit cell is only 2. So coordination number is 8. Why? Because the every body center atom is neighbor to the 8 atom which is located at your 8 corner atom, and body center atom is also the corner atom of your neighbor cell. That's why in this case the coordination number is 8. Now atomic radius. So I think we are very familiar with your Pythagoras theorem. First, consider the right angle ADB. So by using Pythagoras theorem, we know here A is equal to AD is equal to A and BB equal to A. But we don't know your AB. So we can determine first AB. So AB square is equal to DB square plus AD square, or AD square plus DB square. So we have here A square plus A square, that is twice A square, and we have the AB is equal to, see, look carefully what I'm telling you, AB is equal to A root 2. I'm not writing here root 2a, because whenever we write root 2a, sometime exam, in the exam there is a mistake. If you took it long line of your under root, it will be considered a is in the under root. That's why always write a is first and then write the root 2. So a root 2, the value of your AB. So by using this value, again form a one right angle. That right angle is an ABC. So ABC, the whole ABC is a 90 degree. So again use the Pythagoras theorem in this case. Now we know the value of your BC is a, and value of your AB is 2 root, a root 2. So by the Pythagoras theorem, we can determine AC square is equal to BC square, AB square plus BC square. Or we can write down AC equal to root of AB square plus BC square. Now we very well know the value of your AB square is nothing but root 2 bracket square plus A square, that is the height of your unit cell. So we can squaring our approximation, we get the value of your AC is equal to A into root 3. So this is the value of your diagonal, body diagonal of your unit cell. But we know again the value of body diagonal is a 4R. How it's come? Because if you carefully observe in this unit cell, so you'll be fine. So from here to here, so first corner atom is here, having the radius is a R. Then this is the again second corner atom having a radius R, and body diagonal having the radius is a twice R. So from point A to C, we have here R plus twice R plus R, and that is nothing but we determine A root 3. So therefore, 4R is equal to A root 3, or we can write down the simple way, R is equal to A root 3 by 4 is called a atomic radius of BCC structure. So we have here, we determine here number of atom per unit cell, coordination number and atomic radius. So now third, fourth thing we can easily determine, that is a APF, atomic parent fraction or density. Again, it is a cubic structure. So we can determine the volume of your unit cell is nothing but your A cube. Same way, substitute the value of your number of atom per unit cell is a 2, then volume of sphere 4 by 3 pi r cube. So value of r is nothing but a radius of r, a radius of your atomic radius. So that is nothing but a root 3 upon 4 upon a cube. And after calculation, you get the atomic technical density is equal to pi root 3 by 8. So that is nothing but 0.68, or we can call it the 68%. So void space we get here, void space or empty space in this case is a 1 minus 0.68 multiplied by 100 equal to the 32% is a empty space in BCC, and 68% is a actual volume occupied by atom in a one unit cell in case of BCC. So I think it will be clear for you. So if it is clear, so we'll go to the next cell. So next cell is a phase center qubit. So phase center, from its title, it is clear for, in the every cube have a 6 phase, and all phase have a 1 center atom. There is no body center, there is no S center. So if you carefully look, there are 8 atoms located at 8 corner, and 6 atom is located at your face center. So again, in this case, as it is cubic, this case again, A is equal to B equal to C, and alpha equal to beta equal to gamma equal to 90 degree. So number of atoms per unit cell, or average number of atom per unit cell, capital N equal to number of corner atom is 8, that's why 8 by 8. Plus, there is no edge center atom. Edge center means atom is located at your edge center, means here. This is the edge center, or here. This is the edge center, here, the edge center. There is no atom. That's why 0 upon 4 is there. There is a 6 faces, and each faces have a 1 atom, but contribution of that atom, the center atom, is a half. That's why total C atom is 6. So that's why 6 upon 2. And there is no body center atom. That's why 0 upon 1. And total number of atom in a 1 unit cell in case of FCC structure is equal to 4. So coordination number is a very simple in the structure, but slightly difficult to understand it. Because if you compare along x-axis, there will be the one face center atom will be the touch to your four corner atom. So along x-axis, there is 4 atom. Along y axis, there is a 4 atom. And along z axis, there will be the 4 atom. So that's why we have here coordination number 12. Or in this case, every face center atom is a corner atom of your neighbor atom, neighbor cell. So atomic radius is a slightly simple compared to your BCC structure. So AC, again using Pythagoras theorem, AC is equal to under root of AB square plus BC square. And that's why we can hear AC equal to A root 2. So, but we know very well AC equal to a corner atom, two corner atom is there and one is face center. So R plus R, that is twice R, and face center is twice R. So we can write down R plus twice R plus R, that is equal to 4R equal to A root 2, or atomic radius R equal to A root 2 upon 4. So this is the atomic radius in case of your FCC structure. Now again same, the APF we can determine 4 into, why 4? Because I am directly putting in here value. So N is nothing but 4. So therefore N is number of atom per unit cell is a 4 into 4 by 3 pi R cube upon A cube. That is nothing but, so we substitute here the value of your atomic radius A root 2 by 4 bracket cube. So after the simplification, the value will become APF equal to pi root 2 upon 6 equal to 0.74, or we call it in percentage 74% area occupied by atom in a one unit cell. So remaining is a empty. So remaining is a odd space, is a 76% is a empty space in case of FCC. So we have again in the our section, in our syllabus, there is a next structure is a diamond structure. Diamond is a very costly, very hard. We know very well. But determination of same way, all this parameter using is a very simple, but there is a very different one thing, which is maybe you are not aware. So diamond structure, it is difficult to understand, but very easy. So diamond structure is again simple cubic structure. Here is again A equal to B equal to C, and alpha equal to beta equal to gamma equal to 90 degrees. But in this case, is the your previous one structure at all corner atom, there will be the one atom is located, means eight atom at eight corner. There are a six face for one cube. So there are also face center atom. But extra four atom is there. That extra four atom is inside the body, but it is not in the randomly. It has a specific arrangement. The four atoms are along the four body diagonal. Two are in the top, opposite to each other, and two are in the bottom, opposite to each other, and also opposite to the top. Means that we have a total four body diagonal and four atom is along them. But it should be noted that here, if you consider the atom at corner having the your the four body diagonal atom is displaced from your corner atom by 1/4 distance along the body diagonal. This is very important to be known, because to draw this structure is very easy if you understand. But if you don't understand this structure, then you cannot draw it. So how it displaces 1/4 distance along the body diagonal is very important. So here, the distance we can determine again the similar parameter. The I've shown here the parallelogram of carbon atom occupying the tetrahedral side and blue atom of carbon is occupying the F6C position. Basically, the diamond structure is made by penetration in each other by two F6C structure, and it is very easy to determine the number of atom per unit cell, coordination number, atomic radius, and atomic fraction in case of your diamond structure. So, in this case, we'll determine again average number of atom per unit cell. We call it's a capital M. So here is we say that here number of Fermat atom is 8/8. Phase center 6 phase is there. So 6/2 because each phase have a center atom. Then there are the 4 atom inside the body of universal, that's why 4/2. So total number of atom is in this case is a eight atom in this case. This structure is very hard because in this case there are one atom is directly linked with your neighbor 4 atoms and then tetrahedrally with your neighbor 12 atoms. So coordination number of this structure is 12. Atomic radius we know very well the length of body diagonal is a root 3 and the corner atom is displaced by 1/4 of your body diagonal. So corner atom and your body diagonal atom are neighbor to each other. That's why that value is a twice r and it is displaced by your 1/4 of your body diagonal. Hence, we can write down the a root 3 upon 4 equal to twice r, or we can write down, or we can get here the atomic radius of your diamond structure r is equal to a root 3 upon 8. So here is a diamond structure. We have the radius of the atomic packing fraction. In this case, again the volume of unit cell is a cube and atomic packing fraction is equal to n into 4/3 pi r³ upon a cube, that is 8 into 4/3 pi into a root 3 upon a bracket cube upon a cube. So after simplification you'll get here the APF is equal to 0.34, or in percent is 34%. Only the, see, look at here, even there is number of more atom is there, but total volume of atom in occupies in the diamond structure is only 34%. Remaining is empty space. So in this case, the position of your corner atom is at 0, 0, 0, and the body diagonal atom is 1/4, 1/4, 1/4 from your origins. So this is a diamond structure which is very hard because there are every atom is attached with neighbor 4 and neighbor 12 atom. That's why it is very hard. Tetrahedral link is very important. Now the last structure is the hexagonal closed packet. We call it's a SCP structure. So SCP is a hexagonal closed packet. There is also cubic closed packet body center could be closed circuit and so many things. But as per our syllabus, we have a SCP structure. So this is completely different structure compared to your all structure. In this case, it is not cubic structure. First, you keep it in mind. This is a not cubic structure. In SCP, the lattice parameter A is equal to B, but it is not equal to C. Means length and width of this structure is the same, but height is a different. Again, alpha equal to beta equal to 90 degree, but the gamma equal to 120 degree. In this case, the atomic, average number of atoms per unit cell, you can determine by again same formula. So as I told you, the corner atom contribution in the unit cell is depends on structure of unit cell. So it is a not cubic structure. So it is a hexagonal structure. And in this case, the contribution of your corner atom is a 1/6. So in here, we will take here this first corner atom, second corner atom, third corner atom, fourth corner atom, then 5 and 6. There is two face center atom, which we can see here. The face center is on this one, and is on this one. And there is three body, or inside the body there is three atom. So these are the first one. Sorry. Okay. So these are the body along inside the body. So there is a corner atom on top face is a 6 atom and bottom face is a 6 atom. So 2 face is there. So that's why we took it 2 times multiplied 6/6. So that is 1. So there is a 2 atom. Then plus face center is a 2. So that's why 2/2 is a 1 atom at located face center. And inside the unit cell, there is a 3 atom. That's what 3/1. So we have here 2 + 1 + 3. So total number of atom in case of HCP is a 6. So coordination number in this structure is a 12. Because why is 12? Because at its face center atom, we know very well is a face center atom, is a red one. This face center atom, look at your second figure. C atom is at a face center atom up top, which is neighbor 6 atom. So in case of body center 3 atom, it is close to that atom also. And also above of this face center atom, there will be the again 3 atom which would touch that face center atom. So total number of atom is a touch to the that lattice point atom is a 12. That's why coordination number of this structure is not 12. Atomic radius in this case is very easy because distance between your two neighbor point is a nothing but center to center. Center is nothing but an atom radius. And in this case, the distance between A and B point, that is nothing but twice R equal to A, or we can write down the atomic radius R equal to A/2. So here, the area of hexagonal base. Because first we have to be determine area of hexagonal base. So as shown here, second figure, there is a 6 equilateral triangle. We have to determine the area of first triangle and then multiplied by 6. So we'll get the area of one face. And then multiplied by this area with height, so we'll get the volume of a unit cell. So 6 multiplied by, now area of your triangle is 1/2 base, that is A, and height is nothing but pi is in trigonometry, A sine of 60, because it's an equilateral triangle, so that angle will be 60 degrees. And sine 60 is nothing but √3/2. So we have here 6 into 1/2 into A into A into √3/2. That is nothing but √3 A square upon 2, or we can write down it A square 3√3 upon 2. So this will be the area of your hexagonal base or top face, no problem. So after the calculation of area, we have here the volume of a SCP unit cell, V is equal to area of hexagonal base multiplied by height. Now we know the area of your hexagonal base is nothing but what? √3 upon 2 into A square, and height is nothing but a C. So we have here V equal to √3 upon 2 into A square into C is a height. So if you multiply and divide by A, so we get here volume is equal to √3 upon 2 into A cube multiplied by C upon A. But the standard ratio of your base to height of your this cell, the scientist is required the C by A is equal to √8/3 is a ratio of this height height and base. So we substitute the value of C upon A is a √8/3. So V is equal to √3 upon 2 into A cube multiplied by √8/3. So after simplification, you'll get the volume of a SCP structure or unit cell is equal to 3√2 A cube, or we can write down it as I told you earlier, always write down that A cube is before your root value, because sometimes in the exam you will do mistake if you will take it long root, so it will be take in the under root. So always write 3√2 like this. So atomic packing fraction of this structure is now we know the volume of a unit cell is a 3√2. So here the APF is equal to substitute value of your all things, so number of atoms per unit cell, then the volume of your sphere, and value of your volume of your unit cell. So we will get after simplification, if we substitute this all value, atomic radius value and thing, so we will get here the pi upon 2√2, and that is nothing but 0.74, or in the percentage 74%. So this is the atomic packing fraction, means the number of atom is acquired, the total volume in a one unit cell of SCP structure is 74%. The remaining is a 76% is the empty space in a SCP structure. So I think you will understand this all structure. So here the references I use for this presentation, the google.com, it is a, without Google you cannot do any work, and some reference book is here. So thank you very much for your kind attention and patience since almost last 1 hour. Thank you very much. If you have any question, you can ask.
No thank problem. you. Thank you very much, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir, for the nice presentation on crystal structure. You have very lucidly presented the crystal structure topic in this countrywide classroom teaching program. Now I request Dr. Bhupesh Nimbaniwar, sir, to propose word of thanks for this session. Sir, actually, we have another session scheduled at 10 o'clock. And I once again thank you for finishing session within our time.
Yes, sir. No problem.
Dr. Nimbaniwar, sir, over to you.
Thank you, sir. Okay, sir. Awaaz yeto hai, sir?
Yes, sir.
Haan, yeto hai, sir, yeto hai.
Thank you very much, Patil sir, from the Mendai College, Jalgaon. His nice presentation of crystal structure can cover the thoroughly simple cubic structure, simple structure, hexagonal structure, packing fraction, percentage, atomic structure, radius of that, all these things entirely 90% of this unit crystal structure.
Yes, yes, yes.